It's you and Olivia Rodrigo, and things are getting pretty hot and steamy. Suddenly, she puts a hand on your thigh, slowly moving it up, and your family bursts into the room. It's 9 a.m., and they're screaming, "Happy birthday!" Only to reel back in horror and disgust. Right there in your sleeping boxers is a slowly spreading wet stain. Congratulations, you were the victim of a wet dream. Wet dreams are extremely common, and you might be surprised to hear that they happen to both men and women. Men, however, are more likely to experience an orgasmic wet dream, which results in partial or even full ejaculation. Women will often experience vaginal lubrication, but in some cases can also experience a partial or full orgasm. As women's sex organs are internal, it's even more difficult to study their wet dreams as opposed to men, where the evidence can be, well, as obvious as it is messy. Evolution has designed you for two purposes: to create more of the species and to help Super Earth bring managed democracy to space. Your brain is hardwired to procreate, and as a primary function, it is no surprise that it features heavily in our dreams. The amount of sexual activity you have in your real life, or more likely don't have, directly affects the frequency of wet dreams. People who regularly have sex tend to experience significantly fewer wet dreams than Reddit moderators, for instance. Wet dreams are different from a very real medical condition known as sexsomnia. During an episode of sexsomnia, an individual can physically engage in sex acts while still asleep. Wet dreams, however, are purely in the mind, even if the result can be embarrassingly physical. Typically around the age of 13 or 14, you'll experience your first wet dream. But they can happen even earlier during production of testosterone, but before a child has even developed a concept of sex. Yet not everyone will experience a wet dream regardless of sexual activity. No one truly knows what causes wet dreams. Due to a link between high testosterone levels, it's believed that a high sex drive correlates with wet dreams, even if sex isn't actually being had. This correlation also explains why they're the most common during the teenage years, when testosterone production surges. However, if you like to sleep in the buff, you might be more prone to wet dreams. The physical rubbing of your Robert Downey Jr. up against a 500 thread count silk sheet can lead to stimulation during your sleep. With your little soldier standing at full attention and prepared for battle, the mind might naturally produce a scenario to accompany the physical stimulation. The end result is ruined sheets that quickly turn crinkly. Not much is known about female wet dreams and their cause, mostly because even in 2024, good luck finding funding for research studies on female-only issues. If it doesn't affect men, no one's dropping the cash on it. So the best science we have available on female wet dreams stems back to the 15th century and indicates that they're the result of possession by sex demons. Now go watch What Exactly is an Orgasm? Or click this video instead.